Hello friends, I am Satish Paryani, working as an assistant professor in Walchand Institute of Technology in Mechanical Engineering Department. Today, we are at the end of this session, we are able to study the relationship between work study techniques. Now, the contents of this session are work study, techniques of work study, method study, work measurement, and the relationship between work study techniques. Coming to work study may be defined as analysis of the job for the purpose of finding the preferred method of doing it, determining the standard time to perform it by the preferred or given method. Work study therefore comprises of two areas. The first one is method study, which is also called as motion study, where the processes are being set. And second is the time study, which is also called as a work measurement, where we have to note the time, how much time that process or improved process is required. Both can be carried out simultaneously, or the one also can be carried out depending upon whether the process is being stable or process is being accepted. So now we'll note that what the work study means. Work study is a generic term for those techniques, method study and work measurement both included, which are used in the examination of human work in all its contexts, and which leads to systematic investigation of all factors affecting efficiency and economic of the situation under review in order to effect improvement. Now, what are the techniques of work study? First technique is method study. As I told you in previous slide also, it is related to process. It is a technique of systematic recording and critical examination. I am repeating, it is a technique of systematic recording and critical examination of existing and proposed method of doing work for developing and applying easier and more effective methods at reducing costs. And the second one is work measurement. It is application of techniques designed to establish the time for the qualified worker to carry out specified job at defined level of performance. Now we'll come to method study. Method study is mainly concerned with reduction of added work content in the job. It is mostly used to improve the method of doing work or develop an effective method for new jobs. For existing jobs, method study aims to find the better method, which is economical and safe, require less human efforts, or making human life more easier. And third one, needs shorter make ready or put away time. Now the second part of the is work measurement. It is mostly concerned with investigation and reduction of any ineffective time associated with the existing job. Subsequently, establishment of the time standard for the operation which has been improved by the method study. There is no hard and fast rule whether method study or work measurement is to be applied. We can say that if the process has been stable in any organization, we can directly apply the work measurement techniques and reduce their time. Or if we have to improve the process, first we'll improve the process and then we apply the work measurement techniques which is to be applied, and finally we have to improve the productivity which leads to higher productivity. It depends upon whether operation for the job has been perfected or not. If the job operation is perfected, yes, work measurement can be easily or immediate can be applied. If it is not, first the process has been stabilized and then that work measurement techniques or time reduction activity has to be done. Now we see the relationship, a simple diagram which shows the higher productivity related to relationship between the work study techniques. As a work study, as I told you in the previous slide also, work study consists of two major things. First is method study and then is work measurement. Now we see the graph also, in the diagram also, that method study can be carried out or directly work measurement can be carried out. Or after carrying out the method study, we can carry out the work measurement, which leads to higher productivity. Now the method study is to simplify the job and develop the more economical methods of doing the job. So what does that mean? First, we have to select the job, then record the techniques. This recording or selection of the jobs can be done. Selection can be done on the basis of three: economical factors, technical factor, or human factors. Economical factors, whether the job is more costlier, so we have to take into consideration that job. Second, it is human efforts, if it is taking more, so we have to target that job and set that process for doing that job. And third one, technical, if it is leading to every time some technical issues, then the method study again can be carried off, or the process has to be set up again and again. Then the second part in method study comes to the recording techniques. In recording techniques, what is major charts and symbols are being used? The charts and symbols are various. Different charts are being used, different symbols are being used, different activities can be done. So this is one of the, again, the framework where visualization can be done by the management, and the team can come together and decide how that is being performed. So different types of chart: travel chart, string diagrams, and flow charts, man-machine can chart, simultaneously can be seen together, and finally from that chart, examination can be done. The third step in the method study is called critical examination. In critical examination, we have to apply the questions: why that place? For what the reason is being carried out? What is the reason? What are the methods? Why only that method? So different questions are being asked. There are some primary questions. In the future, further slides will understand what is the main reason or main motto in asking the critical examination. So in short, we have to understand in critical examination, what are the primary questions, what are the secondary questions is being asked, and finally that interval. Then finally the analysis comes. In the analysis part, what we have, so there is a, some statistical analysis can be done. The jobs in the statistical analysis, this can be help with the help of different techniques. Many times even the study engineers uses the different techniques like PDPC or Six Sigma also can be used, which are used helpful to carry out further activity of the chart. Now coming to the work measurement. What does this mean? It is to determine how long it should take to carry out the activity. Suppose in this activity, initial job, which current the process in the manufacturing organization, suppose it takes 10 minutes. Now our target is to reduce by 20%. So by seeing now 8 minutes is the target, whether that is possible or not, first thing we have to ask it, or whether the process has to be changed. If the process has to be changed, then method study has been carried out, then work measurement. Now if the process is stable, now we are confirmed that whether now the process has been stable. So what has to be done? So the first part is determine what are the times, what are the allowances given. Now we have to see that there are certain any job or work carries out some observed time. First it is observed time, then second it is multiplied by the factor called the rating factor. And the rating factor, it means whether that part or the job or is being carried out some qualified worker at some higher level or by the at lower level. If it is carried out by higher level, then it has to be normalized. Second, the allowances are to be added. There are some allowances like contingency allowance, interference allowance, which has to be, fatigue allowance, personal allowance has to be added. Now these allowances even has to be added because we cannot assume, or it is not possible that it is continuous, we have to get same output in per hour every time, same and same. So that these different allowances are being added again and again, which leads to final higher productivity. Now, so overall we can summarize the in the work study, there is a method study and work measurement. In the method study, the basic aim of the method study from the work study technique is to simplify the job, okay, and then to develop the more economical methods for doing the job. First, to simplify it, many times simplify the job as possible. We have to simplify lots job, and that job we have to develop the more economical methods of doing that job. The second one in that case is the work measurement. Thus, in the work measurement, what we have done it to analyze, to determine how long that has been carried out. As I have told in the previous sentences also, that work measurement should be carried out to, we have to reduce the time in that case. In that case, we have to, if we are reducing the time, means we are leading to higher productivity. Now there is observed time, rating factor, we have multiplied it, and allowances we have to add it. So this gives us, after giving, see, observed time into rating factor plus allowances give us the standard time. Let us assume that observed time is 10 and that it is fully automatic, so we have to take the rating factor of 100. So 10 minutes plus allowances of 12 persons, so it becomes 112 put together. So how much job? So this is called the standard time. Now in a week, if we assume that 480 minutes are there, if 480 minutes are there in a shift, we can say in 480 minutes how much that jobs can be taken. So this calculation we'll see in the further slides, where finally it leads to a conclusion that with the help of work study, method study and work measurement, we are getting the higher productivity. The references used for this are NPTEL site and the book called Introduction to Work Study by ILO. Thank you.